Hi guys, welcome to our channel. Today's session we are going to discuss about 8085 16-bit multiplication. Already we discussed in 8-bit multiplication functions. Before entering the program, what is the concept of multiplication? So multiplication is a repeated addition function. In 8085 microprocessor, there is no direct multiplication instructions. If you want to perform the multiplication function, you are just applying the repeated addition concept. Just you are entering the program. Before adding the program, first you divide in the two columns. The first column mentions the program counter value. The second column is a mnemonics. So mnemonics is a human understandable language. Just you give the commands. The origin of the program is 2000 H. So 2000 H is the origin of the program. So in this address location, represent the instruction is LFHLD 2050 H. This 2050 is a memory location. So in this memory location, whatever content present, that content is transferred to L register. The successive memory location, that value is transferred to H register. Let us consider the first input value 2050 11. So this content is transferred to L register. Successive memory location 2051. So here also the value is 11. This value is transferred to H register. After execution of this first instruction, L value 11, H value also 11. The next instruction is, it's a 3-byte instruction. You need a 3 memory locations to execute the instruction. The program counter next location is 2003. In this location point, SPHL. So SPHL is a whatever value present in HL register, that content is moved to SP, stack pointer. After execution of this instruction, SP value is 1111. Whatever value present in HL, that content is transferred to SP register. The next location 2004. In this location, the instruction is LHLD 2052. So far, you get the first 16-bit value. Now, you get the second 16-bit value. Let us consider the second 16-bit value 2052. 042053 00. After execute the instruction, H value 00, L content 04. Here getting the 2 16-bit value. First 16-bit value 1111. Second 16-bit value 0004. The next instruction is exchange. Just exchanging the content. Whatever value present in HL register, that content is transferred to DEPAR. After execution of this instruction, DEPAR value is 0004, D value 00, E value 04. The next location 2008. In this location, LXIH 0000H. So in this instruction, declare the H value is 0000. After execution of this instruction, just clearing the HL PAR register. Load 16-bit value. This content is an immediate value. So I represent for the immediate value. After execution of this instruction, HL PAR value now 0000. The next memory location 200B. In this memory location, it hold LXI B 0000. In this multiplication function, you use the repeated addition. So addition program, it produces the two outputs. One is a sum, another one is a carry. The BC pair is mainly used to store the carry value in this multiplication. So beginning of the program itself, you just clearing the BC value, BC register value. After execution of this instruction, BC values 0000. The next instruction, DAD SP. DAD represent for double addition. Just adding the 2 16-bit content. One content you get from the SP stack pointer, and another content you get from the HL. Whatever value present in HL, this content is added with stack pointer. Just you write the binary value of HL. HL pair value is 4 zeros. You write the binary value for HL. All the values are 0. Then you write the stack pointer content. The stack pointer content is 1111111. Write the binary number of stack pointer, adding the two content 1000 1000 1000 1000. So after addition of 2 16-bit value, you can get the result is 1111. The next instruction, the program counter value is 200F. In this memory location, it point JNC 2013. What is JNC? So JNC for jump on no carry. So after addition of these two register content, it produce any carry or no carry. Just check the condition. So in this addition, there is no carry. The condition is true. Once the condition is true, whatever memory locations first in the instruction, that location is moved to the program counter. After execution of this instruction, the program counter value is 2013. So in this memory location, it hold DCXD. Decrement the DE pair value. DE pair value is 0004. After execution of this instruction, DE pair value is 0003. So decrement by 1. The next instruction, move A comma E. Whatever value present in E, so E value is 03. 03 is transferred to A register. Now A register value 03. The next instruction, OR AD. Just applying the OR function with accumulator register and D register. Now the accumulator value is 03. D register value 00. Just applying the OR function, logical OR function, the result is same 03. The next instruction 2016. In this memory location, it hold JN is the 200E. Just to check the condition whether the accumulator value is 0 value or non-zero value. Just you check the result. So in this instruction, jump on no zero. So here also no zero. The condition is true. Once the condition is true, the specific memory location is 200E. You come here. So in this memory location, it hold DAG SP. Again, you add the content from SP and HLPAR. HLPAR value is 1111. Stack pointer value also 1111. You just write the binary number of stack pointer. Adding the two content 1 plus 1, sum 0, carry 1, 100. Likewise, you add this bit also 0100 0100 0100. So after adding this value, here also there is no carry. The next instruction is JNC 2013. There is no carry. Condition is true. Once the condition is true, the program counter value is transferred to 2013. Now decrement the DE pair value. DE pair value now 0002. After execution of this instruction, D value 0002. Next instruction, move A comma E. Now E value is 02. A value 02. After execution of this instruction, A value is 02. Next instruction, OR A D. Just applying the OR function, accumulator and D register. D value 00. Right here, applying the OR function, the result is 0. Again, you come here, JN is the 200E. Here also the accumulator content is non-zero value. The condition is true. Again, it come to 200E. DAG SP. So one more time, you add the content. Now SP value 1, 1, 1, 1. adding the two content 1100, 1100, 1100, 1100. The third addition also, there is no carry. The condition is true. Once condition is true, let's come to 2013. Here decrement the DE pair value. Now DE pair value is 0001. Then whatever value present in E register, the content is transferred to accumulator. After third addition, accumulator content is 01 over AD. Again you apply the OR function with accumulator content and D value. D value 00. Applying OR function, the final result is 01. Again you check the condition whether the accumulator content is 0 or non-zero value. Here also the condition is true. Once the condition is true, 200E, this address location is loaded into the program counter. Again come back here in this memory location. Again DAT SP. One more time, you add the SP content with HL bar. The SP value. Here write again, add the two content 1 plus 1, sum 0, carry 1, 1 plus 1, sum 0, carry 1, 1, 0. Likewise, you add the next 4 bit. So after addition, here also there is no carry. Condition is true. Once condition is true, come here 2013 DCX D. After decrement the DE pair, now all the values are 0. Again, come here move A comma E. Now accumulator content 00. E value is 00. D value also 00. Applying the OR function, the result is 00. JIN is a 200E. Here the accumulator content is a 0 value. Condition is false. Once the condition is false, it ignores the loop. It executes the next instruction. The next instruction memory location is 2019. In this memory location, it point SHLD 2054. This 2054 is a output memory location. Whatever content present in HL pair register, that content is transferred to 2054. The HL pair content you can get from here. So in this point, the result 4444. This 44 is a H register. This 44 is a L register. So after execution of this instruction, 2054 memory location, the L content is transferred to 2054 memory location. First load the L register content. 2055 load the H register value. The next instruction move L comma C. So this BC pair, it store the carry value. In this 4 iteration you don't get the carry value. BC value also 00. First you transfer the C value into L register. The C content is 00. After the execution of this instruction, this content is transferred to L register. Next instruction move H comma B. Whatever value present in B register, that content is transferred to H. So these two instructions just transferring the content from B and C value move to H and L. The next instruction 201E. In this program counter location, it point SHLD 2056. This memory location is used to store the carry value. Now the HL pair value is 0000. This content is moved to 2056 after execution of this instruction. 2056, first move the L register content 00. 2057, let move the H register content. The final location of program counter is 2021. It's a halt. It's declared the end of the program. So hereafter no instruction to execute the program. The input of the multiplication is 1111 0004. Output of multiplication 4444 0000. This 0004 is a iteration. So how many time you apply the repeated addition functions? It's clear. So thanks for watching my channel. Please subscribe. Thank you.